I remember back in the day we didn't used to have too many internet browsers, but with the passage of Android development, each smartphone maker is opting to use their own browser. Today I will be trying to compare the Samsung internet browser and the Mi browser from Xiaomi. Both are available at the Play Store and I will be using an Infinix smartphone so that there will be no bias or more optimization for any browser. I will be comparing their speed, interface, ad blocking system, privacy and private browsing mode, and in the end I will be giving my own conclusion. So first off, I downloaded the Mi browser, which was easy to find, and secondly I downloaded the Samsung browser, which was even easier. Upon opening, you are greeted by lots of permission granting and then it asks you to set it as default browser. Nothing new, as every browser does this. The interface is loaded by newsfeed relevant to your area, and then you can see Microsoft news on the second page. Some popular sites are already pinned on the first page. The menus are kind of overwhelming and I would prefer a lighter and more simpler menu personally. Opening the tabs, you can choose to use the incognito or secret mode, whatever you wanna call it. It also has a dark mode which is kind of gray and not complete black. It also has a feature which lets you download videos from different sites. I tried it for YouTube and it didn't work, which is a good news since Play Store apps are not allowed. Now let's turn on the ad blocking and test it. This is a popular GitHub site to test which kind of ads are blocked by the ad blocker. I tried it multiple times, but the ads served only by Google are blocked, which is not a good news since they are the least harmful ones. Testing the speed of the browser by opening YouTube was fine as any other browser. Lastly, I checked to see if it lets you delete your browser history and preferences, and you can easily do that. Now let's move on to the Samsung internet browser, which is kind of more popular because it is present in most Samsung phones. Upon opening it for the first time, you're greeted by nothing actually, which in my case means a plus point. The menus are sleek and decluttered, which is another bonus point, but it's a personal preference. Some popular sites are already pinned, and let's test the YouTube speed, and it's fine but a tad bit slower than the Mi browser for some reason. It also has a private browsing mode like every other browser. It also has a dark mode which is darker than the Mi's one, and it is also a personal preference. There are no sneak downloading features. You can turn on the ad blocker by downloading the extension from the Play Store. I tried the first recommended one, and let's try it on the same testing site we used previously. On the first attempt, it failed to block any major ads, and which was kind of surprising, but when I turned it on and off from the app and then turned it on and off from the browser, it worked great. It blocked more than half the ads and even the YouTube ads, which I don't recommend blocking as it can hinder the revenue of some hardware creators. In the end, I would choose Samsung browser over Mi's one because of its cluttered menus and less gimmicky features. But it's all personal preference in the end, and you could go with million other browsers on the Play Store, but this is my choice personally. And if you made it this far, what are you waiting for? Go and subscribe for more videos like this. This is Arayz and I'm signing out. Peace.